Hello everyone. In today's lecture, we will discuss how to convert CFG into GNF. The first step in converting CNF to GNF is the renaming of variable. Here we are taking a variable as S, A, B. Now the first step is we need to rename the variable. We are taking S as A1 and we are taking renaming A as A2 and B as A3. Now the production after renaming, converting in A1, A2, 3 would be like first one S equal to A, B would be now written as A1 tends to form A2, A3. Second production A which is forming B, S, oblique B would now eventually form A2 equal to B. Now we have taken B as A3. So in place of B, we will write A3. And in place of S, we will write A1/B. Now the third production where B is forming S A would be written as, we have considered B as A3. Now we will write A3 in place of B and we will write A1 in place of S and A2 in place of A/A. So we have converted the three production S which is forming AB, A tends to imply capital B capital S/B and B which was earlier forming SA/A. We have converted these three production into this form where A1 is forming A2, A3, A2 variable is forming variable A3, A1 and A3 variable is forming A1, A2. The main motive to rename the variable is that when we solve our recursion, left recursion problem, and we will just take a value of, we will find the value of A3, and when we find the value of A3, we will substitute the value of A3 into lower term A2 and A1 to get the combined result. So the main result, main focus of converting, renaming the variable was to find the value of a maximum term, and by finding the value of A3, we will substitute that value of A3 into A2 and A1 to eliminate the left regression. Now, this was a step 1. Now, according to step 2. The algorithm for the step 2 said that we need to convert all the production. We need to convert all the production of form AI which tends to form AJ alpha where I is greater than J into J less than or greater or equal to I. In this step, what we'll do? We are saying that there are three formulas. A1 is tend to imply the form A2 and A3. Here, this one, AI, for this A1 tends to form A2, A3. We are saying that A1 is forming another variable A2 in which J is greater than I. Okay. Now we have seen that in the first step 1, we have renamed the variable as per our convenience to A1, A2, A3. The main motive was to find the value of the biggest variable and then we will substitute the value in remaining variable A2 and A1 to convert into GNF. It will make the process easy.
Now in the step 2, we have, if we, step 2 says that if every production of form where A1 tends to form AJ alpha with I greater than J should be modified to make I less than equal to J. It's mean for variable A1 which is forming A2, A3. It is of form AI. AI means A1. A1 is forming A2 and A3. The first variable of the right hand side is A2. So I equal to 1 in the left hand side and I J equal to 2 as per the right hand side equation. Now we will compare. I is having 1 value and J is having 2 value. In this case I is not greater than J. So we don't need to modify it in order to make I less than J. For second variable, which is A2 tends to form A3, A1. Here A2 is forming a set of variable A3, A1 in which A2 can be considered as AI, and now it is forming AJ alpha where AI is A2. So I is having a value 2 and AJ can be say as compared to A3, and here J is having a value of 3. In this case also I is having a value 2 which is less than 3. So as per the step 2 we have a production in which I is having a value less than J. So we don't need to modify it into I less than equal to J. Now the interesting point of is when we are changing or using A3. So A3 is producing a set of variable A1 and A2. Here when we just trying to convert into this form where I1 is forming, where A of I stands to form AJ alpha. When we are comparing these two equations, then in this case I is having value 3 and J is having value, and J can be having a value 1. See, it's very easy. AI is forming AJ alpha, a set of variable. This is also forming a set of variable equation in which left hand side is having a value of AI. AI is the index. Index I is having a value of 3. So I is having a value of 3 and J is having a value of 1. In this case I is greater than J means 3 is obviously greater than 1. So for this equation A3, A1, A2 we need to modify this equation so that we can get a form in which I should be less than or equal to J. Now this is the interesting point. Now we will see how would we convert A3 into such form of equation where right hand side value should be equal to or less than or greater than value of A3. So we have seen that A3 tends to form A1 and A2, and when we are comparing only we need to check the value of the first variable of the right hand side. In this case it is A1. So we will substitute the value of A1 which is A2, A3. So I am rubbing this part. Now I am substituting the value of A1 in equation number this. Now A3 will form A2, A3 and A2 by substituting A1 as A2, A3. Now in this case also I is having a value of 3 and J is having a value of 2 which is still holding a variable in which I is greater than J. So what we will do, we will try to make this variable as at least convert, we need to convert this variable at least into A3. So we will substitute the value of A2, which is eventually having a variable A3, A1 and slash B. So we will substitute this value of A2 into this equation. It will result into, when we will just put the equation value of A2 in this equation, then it would be A3, A1, A3, A1, A3, A2. And if we will put value of B instead of A2, then it would be B, A3, A2. Now, this is the equation which we have converted using the substitution method. In this case, A3 having a value of I equal to 3 is producing the set of variable in which the first variable is having a value of J as 3. So in this case, I is also 3 and J is also 3. So we have converted the value of this equation where A3 was tends to produce variable A1, A2 with having value of I greater than J. We have converted this equation into finally this equation in which A3 is forming A3, A1, A3, A2 and slash B, A3, A2. So this was the for the step 2 in which we will convert all the production which is tends to form AI equal tends to form AI AJ alpha in which I was having previously having value greater than J. So we need to convert into the form in which the left hand side variable should be at least equal to the first variable of the right hand side. So the next step is to convert or remove the left regression. Hope you are must be familiar how to convert left regression. So if you summarize an equation which is recursively calling itself on the first variable of the right hand side will result eventually result in forming a left regression. So if equation A is tend to form A alpha, then the both the variable of the left hand side and right hand side is same. So it is eventually falling in a left regression. So the solution of this problem is that A would form beta B3, where B3 is a new variable which is given by alpha B3 slash alpha. So beta can be anything, terminal or variable. Alpha can also be a set of variable or terminal as per the requirement of the question. If we analyze among these three equations, A3 is calling A3 itself on the right hand side of the first equation. So it is forming into a left regression. So this term is containing a left regression. We have to remove the left regression. So we will have use this equation or formula, a problem to solve, convert it into a left regression or remove the left regression. Here the term A3, A1, A3, A2 is having a left regression. So if we compare with this equation where A tends to A alpha, this is A, A3 is also A and this part is alpha. And the rest part which is not containing A, this is B, A3, A2, it can be written as beta and this A is also can written as beta. Now the solution of this equation would be A3 will tends to form B, B, A3, A2. We have, what we have to do, we have written this beta here. So we are using this rule, we will write this B, A3, A2 here and now the rest part would be a new variable B3. So it would be a new variable B3 where B3 would consist of alpha B3. So alpha was A1, A3, A2. And B3 slash alpha. If you compare alpha is A1, A3, A2. Now the next variable is of beta is A. If we substitute A in this equation, it would be A and a new variable B3, where B3 is forming A1, A3, A2, B3 and alpha is A1, A3, A2. So by using this equation, we have converted or removed the left regression of A3. Now, the equation A3 is forming. So we have removed the left regression. Now we can compare these two equations. This side is containing these three equations, and now this equation A3, which was earlier containing a left regression of for the this term, have been removed by using this step, and now this production has been written like this. We have got a new term for A3 as this one and this one and B3. This all term has eventually removed the left regression. Now, if we, as you already know, that in GNF, the right side production should be either terminal or should start with terminal followed by any number of variable. So it results in having or turning A3 into a GNF form, in which either term is either terminal or every term is starting with terminal followed by variable. So A3 has eventually be turned into a GNF. Now we will use value of A3 to convert the other terms A2, A1 and B3 to convert into a GNF. So as you might be knowing, in step 1 we have renamed the variable in A1, A2 and A3, and I have told you that if we find the value of the any one variable, then we can use that value for substituting the value in other variables equation to convert into a GNF form. Now we will use the value of A3. Then we will see that A2 tends to form A3A1. So if we substitute the value of A3 in A2, then we will get this should A3 would be replaced by first this value. It would be BA3, A2, B3 and A1. Now this A3 would be substituted by the following combination or the at least value of second variable AB3. It will be result in AB3A1. If we will use this term in place of A3, what will we get? We will simply get BA3 A2 followed by A1. And if we substitute the value of A in place of A3, we will get A1 and slash B. So when we are seeing this equation A2, the first side is a terminal followed by any variable. This is also a terminal followed by variables. This is also a terminal followed by three variables. This is also a terminal followed by one variable, and this itself is a terminal. So eventually A2 has also turned up or converted into a GNF. Now we will use this value of A2 and we will substitute in A1, because A1 is having A2, A3. If we will substitute the value of A2 in this equation, we will result into getting a we will substitute this value in place of A2. It will be held BA3 A2 B3 A1 A3. If we substitute with this value, what we will get? We will get AB3 A1 A3. If we will use this value in place of A2, what we will get? We will get BA3, A2, A1 followed by A3. If we will use substitute this value in place of A2, we will get A1, A3. If we will use B in place of A2, we will get BA3. So, eventually when we substitute the value of A2 in A1, we have found the all these variables or equations is having starting with the other terminal. For this equation starting with B. So, it is in GNF. It is starting with A followed by any variable. Three variables. So, it is also in a GNF. It is starting with B followed by set of variable. It is also in a GNF. And now it is also starting with the terminal followed by two variable. So it has eventually been converted into a GNF. And this is also converted into GNF followed by BA. Oh, it was BA1. BA3. Okay, okay. Now we have converted A3, A2, A1 into GNF. What is left is a B3. B3 tends to form A1, A3, A2, B3 and A1, A3, A2. This side it is not in a GNF form because it is starting with a variable A1. This is also starting with a variable A1. We want to start the right hand production with the terminal. So we will substitute the value of A1 in this B3 equation and it will eventually result in B3 would be, so we will substitute the value of A1 in this equation. So first value of A1 is BA3 A2 B3 A1 A3 followed by A3 A2 B3. Now this value can also be substituted in this side equation. So I am substituting this side value in this equation, in this A1. So it would be BA3 A2 B3 A1 A3 followed by A3 A2. Now possibly similarly this value of A1 can be substituted either to this side production or this side production. It will result in having a value AB3 A1 A3 and followed by A3 A2 B3. And similarly, this side equation will result into AB3 A1 A3 followed by A3 A2. Now we have converted these two values. Now the third value of A1 is BA3 A2 A1 A3. It can be substituted either in this side equation or this side equation. So when we substitute continuing from this side, this term BA3 A2 A1 A3, it would be BA3 A2 A1 A3 followed by A3 A2 B3/. Similarly, this value can also be substituted in this equation. So it will result in BA3 A2 A1 A3 followed by A3 A2. Now when we substitute this value in place of A1 in either this equation or this equation, the result would be A1A3 followed by A3A2B3 followed by this side would be followed by A3A2. So we have substituted this value in this term and this term. So the last term which is remaining is BA3. So BA3 can be substituted either in this part or this part. If we substitute BA3 in place of A1 here, what we'll get? We will get BA3 followed by A3 A2 B3. BA3 followed by A3 A2. And for the last point which I would like to conclude is that in a GNF every term either should contain a terminal or start with a terminal followed by any variable. So A3 is already in GNF, A2 was in GNF, A1 is in GNF. We will see that B3 is also in a GNF. Why? Because it is a first letter is a terminal followed by any variable. This term also containing first letter as a terminal followed by any set of variable. This term is also containing as a first letter as a variable or terminal followed by any set of variable. This term is also containing first letter as a terminal followed by any length of the variable. This is also containing, and the remaining term also contains first letter as a terminal followed by any length of the variable. So there were what in the last what we have done in GNF. In the step 1, we have renamed all the variable using a same convention. It would help in solving any one equation and which will substitute in any other equation A1, A2 and B3 so as to get the value of other equation. And step 2 was saying that for any left hand side which stands to form any production on the right hand side should not contain any value where I is greater than J. So we have to solve all that queries. And in third step, we have to remove the recursion part. Then what was the recursion? Left recursion. If a function is calling itself on the reference side, it's known as left recursion. So in the last part, after solving the recursion, we will substitute the value of any one variable which we have computed, and it will eventually form in converting all the variables in a GNF form. All the rest.